Hello students, ellarigu swagata. Myself Mrs. Bharati Savant, working as a lecturer in GSS PU College, Belagavi. In today's session, let us take a journey through Kingdom Animalia, that is Pranigalu. As per Robert Whittaker's five kingdom classification system, which believes in phylogeny, that is evolutionary interrelationship, animals are placed at fifth position. Animals are eukaryotic, multicellular, known for heterotrophism, motility. Along with that, they have sense organs, neural and chemical coordination. This topic we divide in three parts for the preview. First part is basis of classification. Second part, which includes non-chordates, and third part, which includes chordates. Accordingly, you will expect questions in competitive exams. Let us take a summary of basis of classification. Number one, animals have levels of organization. There are four levels. Cellular grid, in which poriferans are included, we call spongy pranigalu. In tissue grid, we include coelenterates and ctenophorans. We call kutuku kanavantagalu. In organ grid of organization, we include flatworms. We call chapate hulugalu. In organ system grid of organization, we include Aschehelminthes, dundu hulugalu, annelidans, valayankitagalu, arthropodans, sandhipadagalu, molluscans, mrudvangigalu, echinoderms, kantaka charmigalu, and chordates, kasherukugalu. Let us move to the symmetry we call sammiti. Poriferans, they are asymmetrical. Coelenterates and ctenophorans are radially symmetrical, and flatworms till chordata, they are bilaterally symmetrical. Coming to next, when you say tissue grade of development, they are derived from germ layers of gastrula during embryogenesis. When tissue develops from ectoderm and endoderm, we call diploblastic. And when tissues develops from ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm, we call them as triploblastic animals. Moving on to the body cavity called coelom, we call kuhara. It is a space between the body wall and the wall of alimentary canal. If it is reduced, we call as coelomates. Example, flatworms, chapate hulugalu. If this particular body cavity or coelom is found, but mesoderm is in the form of pouches, we call pseudocoelomates. Example, Aschehelminthes, we call dundu hulugalu. When this body cavity is lined by peritoneum, there is a perfect separation of body wall from the wall of alimentary canal. We include the animals from annelida till chordata, that is from valayankitagalu till kasherukugalu. Moving on to the next, segmentation. When animal body is divided externally as well as internally by partitions called septa, we call segmentation. This we found perfectly in annelidans, we call metamerism. It is also found in arthropodans, but again in mollusca, segmentation is not found. Moving on to the next level of organization, it is the presence or absence of notochord. Notochord is a solid dorsal supporting structure which is absent in non-chordates. This is the big group, including the animals from porifera till echinodermata. Then in chordata, notochord is found in primitive chordates like hemichordates, urochordates, cephalochordates, and in higher chordata, This notochord is replaced by vertebral column. Thus, it is the basis of classification. Moving on to the next part, non-chordates, which begins with poriferans, spongipranigalu, aquatic, sessile, sedentary, with ostia, spongocele, canal system, and they reproduce asexually and sexually. Moving to the coelenterates, ctenophorans, diploblastic, radially symmetrical, with coelenteron, having single opening on the hypostome, surrounded by tentacles, having nidoblast with nematocytes. Next, platyhelminthes, which are known for the flat body, no coelom, but here we find sex organs are united, called hermaphrodites. Nervous system is ladder type. Most of them are parasites, having suckers and hooks. Moving on to the aschelminthes, they are pseudocoelomates with unsegmented body, but here we found complete digestive tract, starts with mouth, ends in anus. Moving on to the annelidans, here we find the well-developed organs in each system. First time we can see closed circulatory system. We find cutaneous respiration here. They have locomotory structures like setae, parapodia, and the suckers. Phylum Arthropoda is the largest phylum in kingdom Animalia. They are known for jointed appendages, chitinous exoskeleton, and sense organs like antennae and compound eyes. Let us move to phylum Mollusca, having soft body covered by hard shell. Unsegmented body. Here we find tenidia or pulmonary sacs for respiration. In this, the blood pigment is hemocyanin. Moving to echinoderms, exclusively marine animals. Here, the body is protected by spiny skin. They have water vascular system, tube feet for locomotion. Next is connecting link between non-chordata and chordata. We call hemichordata, example is balanoglossus. Here, the body is divisible into proboscis, collar, and trunk, having lateral gill slits, proboscis glands for excretion. Urochordata is the first group in chordata, having notochord towards the tail region in embryonic life. Moving to cephalochordata, example amphioxus, where notochord is persisting from head to tail region. Next, in vertebrata, notochord is replaced by vertebral column. Here, we divide them in jawless agnatha, example petromyzon, lampreys, and gnathostomata, where the animals have jaws. Further, gnathostomata includes two superclasses, Pisces, aquatic with fins, and terrestrial with limbs. In Pisces, we include cartilage fish Chondrichthys, bony fish Osteichthys, examples Coleodon and Labio. In tetrapodans, amphibia, these are Ubhayvasigalu, reptilia, Sarisrupagalu, birds, that is aves, Pakshigalu, and mammals, Stanyapranigalu. In chordata, we find well-developed circulatory system showing evolution with the well-developed heart, two-chambered in fish, three-chambered in amphibia and reptilia, four-chambered in crocodiles, birds, and mammals. Oviparous, they lay eggs, and some are viviparous, they give birth to young ones. Poikilotherms, Shita Raktagalu, and homeotherms, Ushna Raktagalu. With this brief introduction, I will conclude explanation of kingdom Animalia. I will take you to the question series. Hope before I tell the answer, you will definitely get the answer from the given options. Welcome to question number one. Division of labor among cells is observed in. The options are sponges, cnidarians, flatworms, and roundworms. Here, roundworms belongs to Aschehelminthes, showing organ system grade of development. Flatworms belongs to phylum Platyhelminthes, showing organ system grade of organ grade of development. Cnidarians belongs to tissue grade of development, and sponges are cellular grade, where the division of labor among cells is found. So the correct option is sponges. Let us move to question number 2. When any plane passing through the central axis, I'll repeat, when any plane passing through the central axis of the body divides the organism into two identical halves is referred as. The options are asymmetry, pentaradial symmetry, radial symmetry, and bilateral symmetry. So here the question is based on the symmetry. When a cut passing through any plane will never divide body in equal parts is asymmetry. We found in porifference. Here, any plane passing through the central axis of the body dividing organism into two identical halves is radial symmetry. While only in one plane we can take a cut so that we will get two identical halves is bilateral symmetry. So naturally the correct option is radial symmetry, which we found in cnidarians, which includes coelenterates and ctenophorans. Let us move to the next question. In diploblastic animals, animals are derived from two germ layers. There is an undifferentiated layer present between ectoderm and endoderm. And this particular layer is called as, that you have to find out, mesenchyme, mesoderm, prosenchyme and mesoglia. And the correct answer is mesoglia, which is an undifferentiated layer found in coelenterates and ctenophorans during embryonic development, which separates ectoderm from endoderm. Let us come to fourth question, notochord. It is a solid dorsal supporting structure which we found in chordates and absent in non-chordates. So during embryonic life, this particular structure is derived from. The options are mesoderm, endoderm, epiderm and ectoderm. And here the correct answer is mesoderm. So notochord is a mesodermal derivative. Question number 5. In canal system, just recall the first phylum among non-chordata is porifera, which includes sponges, which are sedentary, cellular grade, asymmetrical animals. They are not moving at all. The body surface is having minute openings called ostia, where the water enters. The water is accumulating in the cavity called spongocele, where the inner lining made up of choanocytes, these are oftenly called as collar cells. They will take the food particles from the entered water, give the waste to it, takes oxygen, give carbon dioxide. So after some time, this water oozes out from the animal body through osculum. So if you recollect my explanation, you can definitely come to the correct option, ostia, spongocele and osculum. So here option D is the correct answer for question number 5. Let us move to question number 6. Again, in porifera, the body is supported by a skeleton, and this skeleton is made up of calcium, silica or spongin fibers, and the name given to these components is spicules. So here in higher animals we find cartilage and the bones supporting the animal body. So here in porifera the skeleton is composed of spicules. So option C is the correct. Let us move to question number 7. This question is based on phylum Coelenterata, showing metagenesis. It is a method in which the animals like Hydra, having polymorphic structures, elongated body, cylindrical with anterior opening on the hypostome surrounded by tentacles, is polyp, while the round umbrella shaped structure developing on the polyp is medusae. So polyp reproduce asexually to give medusae, and medusae reproduce sexually to develop into polyps. This particular process we call alternation of generation, found among Coelenterates. So here polyp produce medusae by asexual method. So option A is correct. Moving to question number 8. The ability of living organisms to emit light. Emitting light is not by the flow of current. It is a natural phenomena which we found in some protozoans, which are unicellular organisms like Nautiluca. And this particular ability we can found in Ctenophorans, which are exclusively marine cnidarians. They move with the help of comb plates. They are always in medusoid form. So this phenomena is known as bioluminescence. So the correct option for question number 8 is bioluminescence. Question number 9. Presence of hooks and suckers. Hooks for attachment or adhesion, suckers to absorb, even they help in adhesion. So hooks and suckers in animals. Just recall phylum Platyhelminthes, which includes flatworms. They are endoparasites. So most of them, they lead parasitic mode of life. They attach to the host body and derive nutrients and whatever they need from them. So here, presence of hooks and suckers in animals is an adaptation for, out of 4 options, showing parasitic life, symbiotic life, competitive life, and predator life. The correct option is A, parasitic life. Question number 10, aquatic annelidans. Usually annelidans are found in moist soil. Most of the annelidans are also found in freshwater bodies. So here, annelidans in which we found the locomotory structures. There are outgrowths from the skin at every segment we call setae. There are paired outgrowths we call parapodia. And there are anterior and posterior round structures we call suckers. Setae found in earthworms. Parapodia found in Neris and suckers found in leech. So here aquatic annelidans use lateral appendages for swimming. This usually found in the animal like Neris. So the correct option is parapodia. 11th, statocyst. As I already told you that the largest phylum, which includes maximum number of animals, is Arthropoda, known for divisions, known for chitinous exoskeleton, known for jointed appendages, and known for developed sense organs. So there is one organ called statocyst. It is, as per option 4, a given organ of support, organ of balance, organ of locomotion, organ of sensation. So this statocyst is an organ of balance. Question number 12. Unsegmented body with a distinct head, muscular foot, visceral mass is found in. The options given are arthropodans, Ascihelminthes, molluscans, and echinoderms. So here in Arthropoda, usually we found cephalothorax abdomen or head thorax abdomen or prosoma, mesosoma, metasoma, or metamerism with jointed appendages. So this is not a correct option. In Ascihelminthes, body is unsegmented, but there are no distinct divisions. So even B option is wrong. In echinoderms, there is a central disc with the ventral mouth and dorsal anus, showing pentaradial symmetry, so even D is not a correct option. So correct option is C. In mollusca, there is an anterior distinct head, dorsal, visceral mass enclosing all the systems, and a ventral muscular foot helps in locomotion. Question number 13. Protochordata includes. Now, what protochordata is? These are primitive chordates having notochord, either at the posterior side along the dorsal line or extending from anterior to posterior region along the dorsal line, which includes the correct option here. We have to find out A is hemichordata and urochordates, B is urochordates and cephalochordates, C is cephalochordates and vertebrates, D is hemichordates and vertebrates. Here, remember, phylum number 10 is hemichordata. Earlier, it was included among chordata, but now it is separated. So, we should not take hemichordata under protochordata. So, protochordata includes urochordates and cephalochordates. So, correct answer is option B. Let us move on to question number 14. Body cavity is the cavity or the space present between body wall and the gut wall. Gut is an alimentary canal, digestive tract. So, in some animals, this body cavity, it is known as coelom. This body cavity is not lined by mesoderm. Such animals are. Here, please remember, this is an important question. If coelom is present, we call eucoelomates or coelomates. If coelom is not found due to flat body, we call them as acoelomates. And when there is a coelom but not lined by mesodermal lining called peritoneum, then we call pseudocoelomate. So for question number 14, the correct option is B, pseudocoelomate. Question number 15 here, please see both the columns showing in column 1 division of labor and in column 2 the animals. Please look at the animals first. Ferretima is earthworm, belongs to Annelida. Fasciola is liver fluke, it is a flatworm. Spongilla is a poriferan found in fresh water. And Obelia is a coelenterate. So, just recall the levels of organization. Organ grade in flatworms, cellular grade in poriferans, tissue grade in coelenterates, we also call it as cnidarians, and organ system grade from Annelida to chordata. So here, when you match both the columns, the correct option is C. Move on to question number 16. There are four options in which you can see the cells. Given below are types of cells present in some animals. Each one is specialized to perform a single specific function, except. So to find out the cells which are not performing specific function in the animals. A, choanocytes, collar cells. They are known for intracellularization in poriferans, so they have their own function. Nematocytes. These are found in nidoblast of coelenterates, helping in defense or capturing the prey. Gastrodermal cells are lining the body wall, helping in digestion. So option B is correct here, where interstitial cells are undifferentiated cells, so they don't have any specific function. Move on to question number 17, cycon, which belongs to phylum Porifera. It belongs to a group of animals which are described as, recall poriferan feature. Remember, all animals are multicellular. So first option gone, where they have written unicellular and acellular. Then B, multicellular without any tissue organization. C, multicellular with gastrovascular system. D, multicellular having tissue organization but no body cavity. As I already told you that cycon belongs to phylum Porifera. So the correct option is B. Multicellular animals without any tissue organization. 18. Cnidarians, which include Coelenterata and Ctenophora. Here, the animals are known as cnidarians because they have special stinging cells called cnidoblasts containing nematocytes. So here you can easily find out the option A. Coelenterates and Ctenophorans, B. Coelenterates and Porifernes, C. Coelenterates and Flatworms, D. Flatworms and Roundworms. So correct option is A. Cnidarians include Coelenterates and Ctenophorans. Question number 19. Ascaris is characterized by absence of true coelom but presence of metamerism, presence of neither true coelom nor metamerism, presence of true coelom but absence of metamerism, D. Presence of true coelom and metamerism. Here, to find out correct answer, recall Ascaris is belonging to phylum Aschehelminthes. So in Aschehelminthes, all animals are pseudocoelomates, means true coelom is absent. Even the body is unsegmented. So correct option is B. Question number 20. The features does not belong to phylum Arthropoda are A. Chitinous exoskeleton, B. Metameric segmentation, C. Parapodia, D. Jointed appendages. The correct option here is C. Parapodia. We don't find these locomotory structures in arthropodans. Question number 21. Select the group of animals belong to the same phylum. To choose correct answer, students, you have to make a list of all the animals which are given as examples for each phylum. And please read it again and again so that finding correct option goes very easy. Here, A. Sponge, C. Anemone, starfish. They will not match because starfish belongs to Echinodermata, sponge belongs to Porifera. B. Amoeba, found in Protista, mosquito in Arthropoda, Tania is tapeworm. Definitely mismatch. C. Earthworm from Annelida, pinworm from Aschehelminthes, tapeworm from Platyhelminthes. So even this option goes wrong. So correct option, naturally D. Prawn, scorpion and locusta. They belongs to phylum Arthropoda. 22nd. Molluscan. The animal belongs to phylum Mollusca. Molluscans are named for soft body protected by hard shell. Depending upon the shell development, they are classified. So here, molluscan named as tusk shell means shape of the shell is like a tusk, that is elephant's tooth. And the most beautiful animal belonging and living inside the tusk shell is Dentalium. So out of four options, Neopelina, Pila, Dentalium, Doris, the correct option is C, Dentalium. 23. The multicellular heterotrophic motile organisms belongs to, very basic question. But sometimes students in overexcitement, they may choose wrong option. So when you start reading the question, give stress on every word, multicellular, heterotrophic, motile. So naturally, as per phylogenetic system of classification, based on which Robert Whittaker classified organisms in five kingdoms, see the option mycota, which includes fungi. Definitely they are multicellular, they are heterotrophic, but they are not motile. B. Plantae, they are multicellular but autotrophic. There is no question of motility. C. Animals. D. Monera. Monerans are not multicellular. They are unicellular prokaryotes. So here correct option is C. Question number 24. Select incorrect statement from the following. Mesoglia is present between ectoderm and endoderm in Obelia. It is a right statement. Radial symmetry is found in Asterias. Asterias is a starfish, belongs to Echinodermata. Fasciola is pseudocoelomate animal, D. Tania is triploblastic animal. Tania is tapeworm from platyhelminthes. Obviously, it is triploblastic animal. So here correct option is fasciola, because this statement doesn't match with the word pseudocoelomate, because fasciola is a liver fluke. It is a flatworm. It is an acoelomate. So incorrect statement is C. Let us move on to question number 25. One of the representatives of phylum Arthropoda, flying fish, it is Exocetus from Pisces. Cuttlefish from different group. Pufferfish is also from different group. Silverfish is an insect. This organism, this animal we found in the book shell. If you keep books for many days, you'll find silver like animal moving here and there, very very delicate. If you touch, you can see the silvery coating on your fingers. So here correct option is C, silverfish. 26. Asterias, starfish. It swim, it respire and excrete. Asterias belongs to phylum Echinodermata, the last phylum in non-chordata. So here there is a specific system present to do various activities. It is water vascular system. Here if you see the option, you'll find water vascular system, so you know already answer for question number 26, but let me explain. Canal system found in porifera. Spongocoel is a part of canal system. Coelenteron is gastrovascular cavity found in coelenterates. 27. A jawless fish which lays eggs in fresh water and whose larvae after metamorphosis return to the ocean. See how funny habitats they are choosing. Means these animals, they lay their eggs in fresh water. Eggs hatch into babies, larvae, and larvae don't want to survive in fresh water. They want to go back to marine waters. So here out of four options, Petromyzon, it is a jawless fish which lays eggs in fresh water and whose larvae after metamorphosis return to the ocean. Petromyzon, commonly known as lamprey, belongs to Agnatha. These are jawless animals. It is a subgroup under vertebrata. Let us move on to question number 28. An important characteristic that hemichordates share with chordates is, please read options carefully. Ventral tubular nerve cord, pharynx with gill slits, pharynx without gill slits, absence of notochord. Already told you hemichordata is separated from chordata now, but they have one similar feature. As per this option is B. They both groups have pharynx with gill slits for respiration. Question number 29. From the following characteristic, one is not shared by birds and mammals. These two groups are well-developed vertebrates. Birds are known for aerial mode of life, they can fly. Mammals are found in variety of habitats. Go through the options. Ossified endoskeleton means endoskeleton made up of bones. Breathing using lungs means they show pulmonary respiration. Viviparity, they give birth to young ones. And D, warm-blooded nature. So if you compare birds and mammals, both have ossified endoskeleton, both show pulmonary respiration, both are homeotherms, warm-blooded. Here birds are oviparous, mammals are viviparous. So from the following characteristic, there is one which will not match, not shared among birds and mammals, is viviparity. Question number 30. Which one of the following sets of animals share a four-chambered heart? Amphibians, reptiles, birds. Definitely no. Crocodiles, birds, mammals. Crocodile is the only one group in reptilia will have four-chambered heart. And remaining two groups belongs to homeotherms, warm-blooded animals. They have four-chambered heart. So C and D, if you see the groups, crocodiles, lizards, turtles, only crocodiles have four-chambered heart. Lizard, turtles, three-chambered. Lizards, mammals, birds. Mammals, birds have four-chambered, but not lizards. So correct option is B here. Question number 31. Choose the pairs of animals similar to each other pertaining to the features stated against them. Ascaris and Cyclostoma both are belonging to Aschehelminthes, so they don't have metameric segmentation. Seahorse and flying fish both belongs to Pisces. They are cold-blooded, we call poikilotherms. Pteropus and Ornithorhynchus, known for viviparity. Garden lizard and crocodile, three-chambered heart. So here, out of four options, B is correct because seahorse and flying fish both are poikilotherms. Let us move on to question number 32. Choose the correct statements. All mammals are viviparous. All cyclostomes do not possess jaws and paired fins. All reptiles have three-chambered heart. All Pisces have gills covered by an operculum. If you see D, Pisces includes Chondrichthys and Osteichthys. Chondrichthys, where gills are open without operculum. And Osteichthys have paired gills always covered by an operculum. So D is not the correct option. C, all reptiles have three-chambered heart. There is one exception here because crocodiles have four-chambered heart. B, all cyclostomes are agnatha. They have jawless opening, which serve as a mouth. All cyclostomes do not possess jaws and paired fins. The correct option is B. All cyclostomes do not possess jaws and paired fins. Move on to question number 33. Again, match the following here. Column A, where you can find phyla. Column B, where we find the specific features. Porifera, Aschehelminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Echinodermata. Just recall their important features. You can easily find out the correct option. This I will leave on you. Porifera, you have to find out the correct option now. Porifera, known for canal system. Aschehelminthes, known for unsegmented body. Annelida, known for metamerism. Arthropodans, known for jointed appendages. And echinoderms, known for water vascular system. So correct option, naturally, C. 34. Hyla. It is an amphibian, commonly known as. Clear? So here, four options are given. Tailed frog, funny thing. Limbless frog, funny thing. Tree frog, poisonous frog. Poisonous frog we call buffo. This is just extra information for you all. Tree frog is common name given to Hyla. It is very small and active frog, which we always found on the trees. So Hyla is an amphibian, commonly known as tree frog. And the last question in my session, flightless bird is. A. Colombo, common name is pigeon. Struthio, common name is ostrich. Neophran, common name is vulture. Corvus, the common name means crow. So out of four options, definitely B, Struthio. It is ostrich, which is a flightless bird. With this, I'll complete my questionnaire. Hope it may help you. Here I have included some questions which are already appeared in previous NEET exams and some are in Karnataka CET exams. With this question series, let me conclude my session by saying few words. I apologize all the students who are from Kannada medium because personally, I am sorry to say this, I am not fluent in Kannada as I reside on border areas and as my mother tongue is Marathi, so unable to explain each and every term in Kannada. Extremely sorry, my dear children. But please try to listen each and every word from the explanation. Definitely, it will help you in solving the questions from Kingdom Animalia, which will come in your future exams. Let me tell you one thing. Children, as you suffered a lot in this pandemic, everyone suffered, but a great salute to you. With positive approach, you are still learning, you are still struggling. Believe, struggle for existence with variations selected by the nature. This is the Darwin's law, where the nature always choose the best one, fit to survive and continue the life, right? And to continue the life, definitely biological processes will help you. With this, I'll say all the best for everything, whatever do you in your future. Thank you very much.